It's nighttime in the big city. A wealthy man terrorizes a waitress. The dogs can smell rain. This is Theme Time Radio Hour with your host, Bob Dylan.
Welcome back to Theme Time Radio Hour. And I couldn't be more excited because today I'm going to talk about nothing. As most of you know, I've studied nothing my entire life, and I like to think I'm a bit of an expert. We're going to be talking about next to nothing for nothing, nothing doing on all or nothing. We're going to be talking about nothing to write home about and nothing to shout about, nothing to sneeze at, good for nothings, and nothing going for you. Much ado about nothing, next to nothing, thinking nothing of it, and having nothing to do with you. In the background, ain't nothing but a G thing from 1992. It hit number one on the R&B and the rap charts, and number two on the Billboard Hot 100. Dr. Dre was a member of NWA, not to be confused with the NRA or the WPA. He went on to have an even bigger career after he left them, not just as a performer, but also as a producer and a talent scout. But perhaps most importantly, it features one of his discoveries, a dog commonly known as Snoop.
It's like that and like this and like that, Anna. It's like this and like that and like this. So just chill to the next episode.
For a chisel, my fizzle. Just because we're talking about nothing doesn't mean I can leave a lot of dead air. So let's get started with a little bit of music. When you're talking about nothing, nobody does it better than the Fugs. And on this album from 1965, one of those subjects was nothing. Here goes nothing, the Fugs.
Sunday, nothing, Monday, nothing, Tuesday and Wednesday, nothing, Thursday for a change, a little more, nothing, Friday once more, nothing, a Monday, garnish, a ding, stick, a garnish, Mitt, Vulcan, garnish, stick, garnish. I take for an oven, a garnish, giggle, a job as light, a garnished. Lunes, nada, Martes, nada, miércoles, y jueves, nada. Vienes por cambio, un poco más, nada, sábado, otra nada. February, nothing. March and April, nothing. May and June, lots more, nothing. July, nothing. Oh, Village Voice, nothing. New Yorker, nothing. Sing out in folkways, nothing. Harry Smith and Allen Ginsberg, nothing, 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 nothing. Nothing, 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 lots of it, nothing, 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 nothing,
not a goddamn thing.
That was the Fugs with nothing. The Fugs were founded by a poet named Tully Kupferberg and a bookshop owner, Ed Sanders. They got together in 1964 They would bash away at their instruments, playing songs that were political, sexual, and satirical. Ed Sanders became even more famous after leaving the Fugs. In the 1970s, he wrote a biography of the Manson family called The Family. Also in the 70s, he spent a long time writing a 900-page biography of the Eagles. It's never been published, and there's a good chance it'll never be published because the Eagles own the rights to it. I think I'd like to read that book. One guy who had plenty to say about nothing was Shakespeare. In A Winter's Tale, he said, "Is this nothing? Why, then the world and all that's in it is nothing. My wife is nothing, nor nothing have these nothings, if this be nothing." In Macbeth, he said, "Life's a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing." In Hamlet, "There is nothing either good or bad, but thinking makes it so." And finally, from King Lear, "Nothing can come of nothing." That was The Cookies, "Don't Say Nothing Bad About My Baby." They recorded this song in 1963, and it went up to number 7. The Cookies were Margie Hendrix, Earl Jean McRae, who I'm pretty sure we're going to be hearing from next week, and Pat Lyles. The Dimension label was actually formed by Don Kirshner as a recording outlet for Jerry and Carol's songs and productions. We're going to move from the Bureau Building a couple of blocks over to the Great White Way. This is a song from the Broadway production of South Pacific. The song was written by Oscar Hammerstein and Richard Rogers. In the original Broadway production, it was sung by Myron McCormick, who played the character Luther Billis. But we're going to listen to it by the great Sammy Davis Jr. He recorded it in 1963 for Frank Sinatra's Reprise record label. Here's Sammy, who knows for sure there is nothing like a dame.
We got sunlight on the sand, we got moonlight on the sea, we got mangoes and bananas you can pick right off a tree. We got volleyball and ping pong and a lot of dandy games. What ain't we got? We ain't got dames. We get packages from home, we get movies, we get shows, we get speeches from our skipper and advice from Tokyo Rose. We get letters doused with perfume, we get dizzy from the smell. What don't we get? You know darn well. We got nothing to put on a clean white suit for. We got nothing to look masculine and cute for. There is nothing like a dame, nothing in the world. There is nothing you can name that is anything like a dame. We feel lonely and we long for the fair and gentle sex. We would like to feel the feeling of some arms around our necks. We feel hungry as the wolf felt when he met Red Riding Hood. Now what don't we feel? We don't feel good. Lots and lots of things in life are beautiful, but brother, there is one particular thing that's nothing whatsoever in any way, shape, fashion, or form to do with any other. There is nothing like a dame, nothing in the world. There is nothing you can name that is anything like a dame. There are no books like a dame, and nothing looks like a dame. There are no drinks like a dame, and nothing thinks like a dame. And nothing acts like a dame, or attracts like a dame. There ain't a thing that's wrong with any man here that can be cured by putting him near a girl, a woman, a female, feminine dame. There's nothing like a dame.
That was Sammy Davis Jr. There's nothing like a dame. Nothing like a babe. Nothing like a chick, nothing like a chippy. Nothing like a doll or a kitten. Nothing like a looker or a skirt, a tomato or a dish. You'd have to write a whole different song if it was called There's Nothing Like a Dish. Here's some words about nothing by Gene Passavant. It's called Neil. It goes like this. Nothing is richer than precious stones than gold. Nothing is finer than adamant. Nothing nobler than the blood of kings. Nothing is sacred in wars. Nothing is greater than Socrates' wisdom. Indeed, by his own affirmation, nothing is Socrates' wisdom. Nothing is the subject of the speculation of the great Zeno. Nothing is higher than heaven. Nothing is beyond the walls of the world. Nothing is lower than hell or more glorious than virtue. Jean Passerat, nothing poet. And I don't mean that judgmentally.
Do you know what the word nada means? In all those Mexican movies you made,
isn't that a light chicken gravy that you do?
It means nothing. Zero. Zip. It's what you're going to have when I'm through with you.
This is Theme Time Radio Hour, where we're talking about nothing. Nada. We're talking about the goose egg. Zilch. Zip. And not. If you are going to say nothing, you got to keep them sweet, as our next artist is going to tell us. This next record was written by Ronnie Self, who you might remember from my dog show. He did that song called Ain't I My Dog, but he also wrote this next song for Brenda Mae Topley, who recorded as Brenda Lee.
Brenda Lee, she's a cutie, flighty as a butterfly.
Now, Brenda was only 4'9", and when she opened in Paris in 1959, people kept writing letters to the newspapers because her press pictures showed the young girl in her school clothes. Nobody could believe that such a big voice could come out of a little girl. While her manager had the great idea to start a story which ran in the French newspaper that Brenda was actually a 32-year-old midget. Brenda and her manager denied the story publicly, but it was still great publicity for her.
Uh-huh, honey.
Here's that big-voiced little gal, Brenda Lee.
All right.
And Sweet Nothings.
My baby whispers in my ear. Secret baby, I keep 'em to myself. Sweet nothing, sweet nothing. We walk along hand in hand, sweet nothing. Yeah, we both understand, sweet nothing. Sitting in class or trying to read my baby, give me that special look. Sweet nothing, sweet nothing. That's enough for tonight. Sweet nothing. Sweet nothing. Sweet nothing. Sweet nothing. Sweet nothings.
That was Brenda Lee and Sweet Nothings. In 1990, a miniature rose was named for Brenda by the American Rose Society. It's a yellow rose with pink or red edges, and it's smaller than other miniature roses. It's kind of a miniature rose. We got nothing else going on, so why don't we check to see if we got some email? Let me just pull one out. This is from Bill Scheel in London, Ontario. Bill writes, "Dear Theme Time, I really enjoy your show. A couple of weeks ago, you played a country song about a couple that wasn't getting along. Could you tell me the name of it?" Well, Bill, you're going to have to give me more information than that. That could be any country song. Bill continues, "I enjoyed the song because it reminded me of my life. I've been married for 3.5 years, and my wife and I have spent 3 of them fighting. We've been to couples counseling, we've seen mediators, we've gone to therapy. I'm afraid the next stop is lawyers. I love her, and I want to stay with her. Do you have any advice?" Well, Bill, first of all, let's say you do get divorced. You can start writing country songs. If you don't want to change careers, and you want to stay with her, I do have one piece of advice. I call it a Theme Time Radio Hour silent treatment. Here's what you do. You and your wife sit in a room, just look at each other, and nobody says nothing. Just keep quiet. Eventually, you're going to want to talk. Don't. This is where most people make their mistake. The frustration works its way to the surface, and whatever you say will just make the other person angry. Keep quiet a while longer. Look at the other person. Remember why you were with them. Finally, you'll know it's time to talk when you remember how much you've missed them. The silence you hear is what your life will be like without them. Sometimes it's important to just take the time to remind yourself why the other person is there. I guarantee it'll work. There you go. You got Freudian therapy, Jungian therapy, Reichian therapy, and now Theme-Timian therapy. You know which one my money's on. All my advice should be taken with a grain of salt. I know a little bit, but truth be told, when it comes to knowledge, I got plenty of nothing. And here's Frank Sinatra to sing about it.
I got plenty of nothing, and nothing's plenty for me. I got no car, got no mule, I got no misery. Folks with plenty of plenty, they got a lock on the door, afraid somebody's gonna rob them while they're out a-making more. What for? I got no lock on the door, that's no way to be. They can steal the rug from the floor, that's okay with me, cause the things that I prize, like the stars and the skies, are all free. Say, I got plenty of nothing, and nothing's plenty for me. I got my gal, got my song, got heaven the whole day long. Got my gal, got my law, got my song. Nothing, and nothing's plenty for me. I got my gal, got my song, I got heaven the whole day long. Got my gal, got my love, got my I saw.
Frank Sinatra, got his gal, got his song, got heaven the whole day long. Indeed. That's from George and Ira Gershwin and Du Bois Heyward's Porgy and Bess. George Gershwin wrote 700 pages of music for Porgy and Bess, and Ira and Du Bois wrote the lyrics. According to Gershwin's biographer, he never quite ceased to wonder at the miracle that he had been its composer. He never stopped loving each and every bar, never wavered in the conviction they had produced a work of art. Porgy and Bess was a slow starter, but it ultimately had staying power. The story of Porgy, Bess, and sportin' life down on Catfish Row is still performed to this day. Songs from it, including Summertime and the one we just heard, have become standards. I was at Staples buying some yellow legal pads, and I ran into Amy Sedaris. I told her about this week's show, and she told me something you got to hear.
When it comes to doing nothing, like tanning to me is nothing. I really like to just lay out on the beach. When we were growing up, we had tanning contest. And whoever got the darkest, you got a sash, an emollient queen sash. And we would set up the main bedroom as the emollient center, and everyone would contribute their lotion, you know, my family. And then each night, we were all responsible for some kind of entertainment. So I might teach you how to side tan, you know. But nothing to me, that tanning's not, it's pretty boring, but I can do that. Just lay around and do apps, like your bones leave your body, that kind of feeling.
Thanks, Amy. I first heard this next record when it was on a compilation called Godless America, and that's about all I know about it. Here's Harry Johnson with a song about a bar fight, It's Nothing to Me.
Take your drink to the end of the bar, buddy. Let her stay there. Now don't be a fool. I'd as soon have a hot seat in Sing Sing prison than to sit down by her on that stool. What's that you say? I guess you're right. It's nothing to me. See that man, she belongs to him. Buddy, better drink up and go while you can. I can tell by the way he looks at you, buddy, that he's sure a quick-tempered, jealous man. What's that you say? I guess you're right. It's nothing to me. There you are, stretched out on the floor, buddy, now you see what you made him do. Here they come to take him off to jail, buddy, and tomorrow someone will bury you. Oh well, that's life, or it was. It's nothing to me.
That's Harry Johnson, Ain't Nothing to Me. Always enjoy a song with a story attached. It's like getting a two for one. And he makes a good point. Mind your own business. You don't have to get involved. You don't know the whole story. Before you go jumping in, take a moment. Look at the situation. Ask yourself, will I really be making this better? I guarantee you, 9 times out of 10, the answer is no. Ariel Durant once said, "One of the lessons of history is that nothing is often a good thing to do and always a clever thing to say."
Nothing is not really very much. I hate to even think about it. Does it annoy you? I fear nothingness. What can it do? There's so little of it. There's none of it. How can nothing do something? Nothing can do everything. Think about nothing for a while. I can't. Why not? There's nothing to think about.
We've had Peter Wolf on the show a couple of times. He's always fun to talk to, and he makes great records. This is from a record he made a couple of years ago from the Sleepless album, and he's got a little bit of help from his man Mick Jagger. There's nothing but the wheel.
Well, I'm past the boulevard, out here underneath the stars. I've been flying past the houses, farms, and fields. Rushing through the cold night air and holding on to nothing but the wheel. Staying clear of the interstate, I'm seeking out those old two lanes, trying to explain the way I feel.
Pete Wolf, little help from Mick Jagger, Nothing But the Wheel, staying clear of the interstate, seeking out those old two lanes. Pete, I know just how you feel. There's a lot of famous road trips. There's Lewis and Clark, Neil Cassidy and Jack Kerouac made one. Ken Kesey took a bus full of people. Dennis Hopper and Peter Fonda made Easy Rider. One of my favorites is the one Michael Paterniti made. He drove in a Buick Skylark across the country with the doctor who performed Albert Einstein's autopsy. There was a third passenger in the car. Well, kind of. It was Albert Einstein's brain, which the doctor had kept for more than 30 years. The brain was in a Tupperware container, and Paterniti bonded with the dead scientist and had many conversations with him. At one point, having the Tupperware container on the pillow next to him as he slept. There's lots of stories about famous brains that were kept after the owner's death. Some people say they saved JFK's brain, and somewhere, the frozen head of Ted Williams waits for the day when science can grow him a new body. I wonder if the new body will bat righty or lefty.
Hi, this is Luke Wilson. You're listening to Theme Time Radio Hour with Bob Dylan.
Maria Magdalena Dietrich von Loesch was born in Schönberg, Germany in 1901. During the 1920s, she worked in the German theater and film world and broke out internationally when she appeared in The Blue Angel, directed by Joseph von Sternberg. She became an American citizen and worked really hard in the war effort during World War II, recording anti-Nazi propaganda in her native German. She received the Medal of Freedom and the Chevalier of the French Legion of Honor. She started making records in the 50s, some of them being backed up by a very young Burt Bacharach. She was very supportive of Burt. Backstage at the Edinburgh Festival, 50 fans were waiting for her. They all were asking for her autograph, and she said, "You don't want my autograph, you want his." This is back in 1958, before anyone heard of Burt Bacharach. Here's a song of hers from 1954, though it was heard more recently in the soundtrack of the film Fight Club. Here's Marlene Dietrich.
No love, no nothing, until my baby comes home. No sir, no nothing, as long as baby may roam. I promise him to wait for him till even Hades froze. I'm lonesome, heaven knows, but what I said still goes. No love, no nothing, and that's a promise I'll keep. No fun with no one, I'm getting plenty of sleep. My heart's on strike, and though it's like an empty honeycomb. No love, no sir, no nothing till my baby comes home. No love, no nothing until my baby comes home. No, sir, no nothing, as long as baby may roam. I promised him to wait for him till even Hades froze. I'm lonesome, heaven knows, but what I said still goes. No love, no nothing, and that's a promise I'll keep. No fun with no one, I'm getting plenty of sleep. My heart's on strike, and though it's like an empty honeycomb. No love, no nothing, no baby no sleep, no nothing till my baby comes home. Why don't you come home, baby?
Boy, what can you say about that? Just fabulous. No love, no nothing on the Columbia record label. Back when there was a Columbia record label. Marlena Dietrich here on Theme Time Radio Hour, where we're talking about nothing. Tao Te Ching said we shape clay into a pot, but it is the emptiness inside that holds what we want. The idea of nothingness is central in Zen Buddhism. Zen is the mystical school of Buddhism. It's not really a religion. There's no god to worship, no ceremonies, no heaven. It's all about the understanding and the attainment of nothing as the path to both spiritual peace and deep understanding. This is the nothing of potential, the empty vessel waiting to be filled, because only in nothing is there room for something. I'm reminded of the Zen Buddhist who went up to the hot dog vendor and said, "Make me one with everything." Here's a native of Monroe, Louisiana, with his one big hit. But as we always say, a song this good, you only need one. Here's Toussaint McCall, playing organ and singing, "Nothing Takes the Place of You."
I moved your picture from my wall, and I replaced them, both large and small. And each new day finds me so blue. Nothing takes the place of you. I read your letter one by one, and I still love you when it's all said and done. And oh, so blue, because nothing, oh, nothing takes the place of you. I write this letter, it's raining on my window pane, and I feel the need of you, because without you nothing seems the same. So I'll wait until you're home. Again, I love you, but I'm all alone. And oh, my darling, I'm so blue, because nothing, oh, but nothing takes the place of you.
That was Toussaint McCall. Nothing takes the place of you. One place where nothing takes the place of you is in a game of Scrabble, especially when you're stuck with the cue. But luckily, there's about 20 words that are legal to play in Scrabble that can be made without a U. Here's a couple of them you might want to have in your back pocket. And unless I tell you otherwise, these can all be pluralized. QAT is the leaves of a shrub, which could be chewed like tobacco or used to make tea. Quindar, Q-I-N-D-A-R, it's a subunit of Albanian currency. Qwerty is a type of keyboard named for the order of the letters on it. And perhaps most exciting for Scrabble aficionados is one of the five new two-letter words that were recently added to the dictionary. Not only does this word only have two letters, but one of them is Q, and the other one isn't U. The word is QI. It's a variation on Qi, the circulating life energy thought to be inherent in all things. The only drawback is that it cannot be pluralized. I'll see you at the tournament. This is Theme Time Radio Hour, and we're talking about nothing. Let's go to the phones. Oh, they're all lit up. Well, let's just try this one. Hello, caller. You're on the line.
Hi, Bobby. I am listening to your show about nothing. And, boy, it really is perfect for me because I have nothing going on right now in my life.
Well, it's not fair to say that.
Well, it's my life, and I'll tell you, there's nothing happening. But I just wanted to say, you know, Mose Allison did a great song called Ain't Got Nothing But the Blues, and I'm wondering if you could play that one.
Well, we'd be happy to.
Sometimes I feel like that's just what I got, nothing but the blues, man.
Well, thanks for calling, and we're going to get it on for you right now.
Okay, thanks so much. And by the way, Q-O-P-H is also an acceptable Scrabble word.
Thanks a lot for calling.
All right, bye-bye.
Well, I don't believe she's got nothing going on. If nothing else, she's got great taste in music. Here's Mose Allison doing the Duke Ellington song, I Ain't Got Nothing But the Blues.
Ain't got the change of a nickel. Ain't got no bounce in my shoe. Ain't got no fancy to tickle. I ain't got nothing but the blues. Ain't got no coffee that's perking. Ain't got no feelings to brew. Don't have a dream that is working. I ain't got nothing but the blues. The band is swinging, the folks are singing. I just can't let my head down. Believe me, Pruitt, ain't nothing to it. Since my little baby left town, ain't got no rest in my slum. Don't have no winnings to lose. Ain't got no telephone number. Got nothing but the blues. Stomping, the folks are romping. I just can't let my head down. Believe it. I can't get with it. Since my little baby left town, ain't got no house in Westchester. Don't have no Chris Craft crew. Ain't got no Basie with Lester. I ain't got nothing but the blues.
That was Moles Allison, Ain't Got Nothing But the Blues. By the way, the word ain't first appeared in English in 1778. It evolved from an earlier word, ant, A-N apostrophe T, which was from about almost a century earlier. It was a contraction of are not and am not. It's from the same period of time when words like don't and won't became part of the vocabulary. Some of these contractions came under criticism in the 1700s. People thought they were low class and devaluing the language. Don't and won't became perfectly acceptable, but ain't was like its poor cousin. It was considered a vulgarism, but no matter how they tried to stamp it out, it's like a weed, and more people are using it. People use it in place of is not, has not, have not, and many other phrases. Perhaps because people use it for all these negative terms is the reason why people view the word itself in such a negative manner. There's no good alternative for the word. Aren't I is perfectly acceptable, but it seems somewhat illogical, and am I not seems overly formal and fussy. So until they find a better alternative, I ain't gonna stop using it, and neither is Mac Curtis, who's gonna tell us all about something that ain't nothing but right.
Now I work hard and I draw my pay, so when the work's done, I like to play. And I like my woman to hold me tight. That ain't nothing but right. Oh, that ain't nothing but right, baby. That ain't nothing but right. Don't rub me wrong and I'll string along, but that ain't nothing but right. I like my coffee strong. I like my auto big and long. Well, I love my woman all day and night. That ain't nothing but right. Well, that ain't nothing but right, baby. That ain't nothing but right. Don't rub me wrong and I'll string it on. Well, that ain't nothing but right. I like to cuddle up when it's cold. I'd rather make love and fuss and fight. Cause that ain't nothing but right. Oh, that ain't nothing but right, baby. That ain't nothing but right. Don't rub me wrong and I'll string along. Cause that ain't nothing but right. You made the whole wide world believe, but if a man needs a woman to hold him tight, that ain't nothing but right. Lord, that ain't nothing but right, honey. That ain't nothing but right. Don't rub me wrong and I'll string it long, cause that ain't nothing but right.
That was Mac Curtis, a little bit of rockabilly from a label usually not associated with rockabilly, but they had a few good ones. Sid Nathan's King Label out of Cincinnati. Let's listen to a little bit of Sid addressing the troops.
Don't forget, we're in the Midwest, and we are not contaminated by New York or Los Angeles or Chicago. Godspeed, let them do what they want to do. That's their business. King, however, and their affiliates are my business, and I'm going to see that they're run to the best of my ability. The day will come when I will have passed on, and maybe King will be better for it. I don't know. But I'm going to wait because I don't have any contract with God.
Ain't that something? King said on Theme Time Radio Hour.
Oh, nothing. Still talking about nothing. Don't want to do nothing. Nothing, nothing at all.
If you only know our next artist from the big hit he had called My Toot Toot, you're missing out on some great swamp blues. Rockin' Sydney played harmonica and guitar and sang all through the South in the late 50s and early 60s. Floyd Swallow, who ran the legendary Floyd's Record Shop down in Villa Plata, Louisiana, signed him to his first record label, Gin Records. Sydney returned the favor by giving him this local hit. You ain't nothing but fine. Here's Rockin' Sydney.
Little girl, let me walk you home. You shouldn't be walking all alone. Little girl, let me walk you home. You know I won't do you no wrong. Come on and tell me what's your name. Little girl, let me hold your hand. Come on and try and understand. I wanna be your candy man. 'Cause you ain't nothing but fine, fine, fine. You ain't nothing but fine.
Like me playing harmonica. Short and sweet with a steady beat. That's Rockin' Sydney on the Gin record label. You ain't nothing but fine. You're on Theme Time Radio Hour. We got time for one more. This is the late Towns Van Sant. He's in pain live with a song about nothing. As a matter of fact, it's one of Elvis Costello's favorite Towns Van Sant tracks of all. Here's Elvis talking about it.
Nothing is a very difficult subject to talk about. One of the most chilling songs I know. So about a frame of mind that I'm sort of glad I've never been in. And I suppose sometimes it's one of those songs that's a little bit hard to even listen to because of that, but beautiful nonetheless. Nothing by Towns Van Zandt.
Hey mama, when you leave, don't leave a thing behind. I don't want nothing. I can't use nothing. Take care into the hall. And if you see my friends, tell them I'm fine. Not using nothing. Almost burned out my eyes. Threw my ears down to the floor. I didn't see nothing. I didn't hear nothing. I stood there like a block of stone, knowing all I had to know, and nothing more. Man, that's nothing. Brothers, our troubles are locked in each other's arms. You better pray that they never find you. 'Cause your back ain't strong enough for burdens double fold. They'll crush you down, down into nothing. Being born is going blind. bind down a thousand times, decals strung on pure temptation. Sorrow and solitude, these are the precious things and the only words that are worth remembering. Friends, tell them I'm fine, not using nothing.
That was Nothing by the late Towns Van Zandt. By the way, Alison Krauss recorded this one on a record that T-Bone Burnett produced. This is Theme Time Radio Hour, and unbelievably, we spent the whole hour and talked about nothing. We've learned nothing, and we've accomplished nothing. And I certainly hope you've enjoyed it. Seems every show we find a quote by Benjamin Franklin. He sure was a smart guy, and he had something to say about nothing. It was, blessed is he who expects nothing, for he shall never be disappointed. We'll be back again next week, and with any luck, we'll talk about something. We'll see you then.
Thanks for listening to Theme Time Radio Hour with your host, Bob Dylan. Produced by Eddie Gorodetsky, and the associate producer is Anita Fitzgerald. Continuity is by Eats Martin, and the editor is Damian Rodriguez. The supervising editor is Rob McCumber. The research team is Diane Labson and Bernie Bernstein, with additional research courtesy of Lynn Sheridan, April Hayes, Callie Glavin, Terrence Michael, Sean Patrick, and Matthew Meltzer. Robert Bauer was the librarian, and the production coordinator was Debbie Sweeney. Special thanks go out to Randy Azrati, Coco Shinomiya, Simpsons Diner, and Lee Abrams. Tex Carbone was our director of studio operations. Recorded in Studio B of the historic Abernathy building, built in 1848. It's a Greywater Park production in association with Big Red Tree. This is your announcer, Pierre Mancini, speaking. Don't miss next week's show. It's all about something.